I'm about you all, but the bit is hot and tight is dead. There won't be any show tonight. I'm sorry, folks. I'm so sorry to let you down, but the bit is hot and tight is dead. There will not be any show tonight.
Completely unknown of a God-fearing way, she stood totally naked in her iron cage. She gained fortune and fame by not wearing a scrap hat only the privates that lifted her lack. When death met her death, death her left her to rot, old natural and in for our hot Miss Hottentot. And rot, yes, she would have, right down to the bone, had not the doctor put her corpse in his home. She a soul which is mounted on Satan's warm wall while her flesh has been pickled in science's hall. Southern Africa, early 1800s. The girl on hands and knees scrubs the vast floor. She's vigorous, meticulous, the floor shines. The man and his brother are deep in conversation.
So you finance me, yes or no?
Last time you wanted money, let's see. What was it? Damn, it slips my mind. Nope, I've got it. A menagerie. God's entire kingdom all under one roof. A miserable failure.
I didn't know they died in captivity.
Should have figured on that one, brother.
I fed and I watered them.
An animal needs more than that, but God knows you never were a farmer.
Never was, never will be. Hey, girl, Murray, you missed the spot.
Presenting the African dancing princess. She'd make a splendid freak.
What's all your finance me, yes or no?
I need to think of it.
What is there to think of? A simple 2-year investment, I'll double. No, I'll triple your money.
You need a girl. Who go all that way to be a dancer?
Well, finding a girl is the easy part. We'll take nothing. She's bigger, particular.
You don't know her?
Well, I can't say I do. Well, you say you're gonna back me? Come on, say yes!
Scheme 3. You went to Timbuktu?
What of it?
Timbuktu to collect wildflowers, garden exotica, admission 2 cents?
You didn't take, I thought it was 2 cents.
I lost my shirt!
And like a lizard, another one grew back in its place! Now back me, man, I have done the research, I know this scheme will bite.
An African dancing princess.
Yeah, the English like that sort of thing.
You really don't remember that girl?
Well, not from this angle. But listen, there's an actor, a whole bunch of them. Not too many dark ones, so I figured that's how we're gonna make our money.
An African dancing princess.
Come on, man, I beg you, hold my hands and knees.
Get up, you got it.
All right now, just like a brother.
I am your brother. You really don't remember that girl, though?
Elijah.
Scheme 1.
Man's with the hot top? That's her?
Father recognized the joke straight off, but mother, poor thing, she still gives you funny looks. You were barely 12.
She's grown since then.
As they all do. Big bottom girls, that's their breed. You were at one time very into it.
Big bottom girls, eh? Analogy. Watch this, brother. What's her name?
Her? Sarah. Little Sarah.
Love. Girl? Girl!
Sir?
Dance.
Dance?
Come on now, get up! I cut the time for you, dance! African dancing princess!
princess. Me.
You'll be like Cinderella?
She do know who Cinderella is, right?
Oh, princess overnight.
That's it.
You'll be a sensation.
No, I'm a little shy.
Well, what's there to be shy about?
Will I be the only one?
Why no, it'll be a whole street full of
street? No, I'm shy.
What is there to be shy about? 2 years worth of working, you come back here rich.
Well, I'd be rich?
You make a mint?
A mint? A mint. How much is that?
You wouldn't have to work no more.
I'd have a house. I would hire help. I'd be rich. Very rich. Big bags of money.
Exactly.
I like it.
You settled me.
You're a rascal, brother.
Well, can I think of it?
What do you want to think of? Well, think of it as a vacation. 2 years work to work, take half the take. Settle then.
Go on, girl. Think it over. Think it all over. What an odd laugh.
Oh, I only got one question. When do we leave?
Next stop?
You've seen the Golden Avenues.
Oh, boy.
room. Yeah, we gonna make a mint together.
Right, girl, good luck. We could stand here and tell her some lies, or the bald truth, that our life will go from rough to worse. You're a fool, girl.
You're the fools. You're the fools. Sitting around here in the dark. You smell. Keep your distance. I'd rather sit here by myself than be called names.
I remember my first day here. Didn't know which end was up and had jet lag to boot.
Poor girl. We should have said nothing. Nothing at all.
What difference could it make? She sunk. Sunk like the rest of us.
Welcome.
Welcome to the club, sweetheart. There's no escape from this place.
On one end of town, in somewhat shabby circumstances, a young woman bears her bottoms. While on the other end of town, in a very different place, we witness a very different scene, presenting For the Love of Venus. Coffee, darling?
No, thank you.
Tea?
No, thank you.
Chocolates?
Chocolate. No, thank you.
Oh, look, what a treasure.
Banana.
You peel it.
Peel it. Novelty.
Uncle took Dad to Africa. Showed Dad stuff. Blew Dad's mind. The man who has never been from his own home is no man. For how can a man call himself man if he has not stepped from his own doorstep and wandered into the world? visit the world, and man he shall be.
You wrote me once such lovely poetry.
His place in the great chain of being is then to him and to all that set their eyes upon him thus revealed.
My love for you, my love, is artificial, fabricated, much like this epistle. Such poetry you used to write me.
Beholding and beheld as he is seen through the eyes of the great know-not, taking his rightful place among the splendors of the universe. Among the splendors of God's universe, it should be, don't you think?
Ah, me. I'm loved.
Note 2, historical extract, category medical. Autopsy report. Her brain immediately after removal, deprived of the greater part of its membranes, weighed 38 ounces. Her spinal cord was not examined, as it was considered more desirable to preserve the vertebral column intact. The dissection of her nerves, although carefully made, revealed no important deviations from the ordinary arrangement. Her liver weighed 54 3/4 ounces and was of a ruinous color and slightly fatty. Her gallbladder was small and a little dilated at the fundus, being almost cylindrical when distended with air, length 4 inches. Her stomach was of the usual form, small intestines measured 15 feet. Spleen was pale in color and weighed 2 1/4 ounces. Her pancreas weighed 1 3/4 ounces. Her kidneys were large.
Come on, girl, strip down, come on, let's go! Come on, girl, faster! Get all off now, I gotta clean it up. Come on, girl, go! Oh, and give me that pato around your room apart.
You know you don't come off. It's custom.
Okay, fine. Well, good God! Girl, he wasn't lying! You got enough back there to make a problem, right? Today is my lucky day.
Well, what's that?
Well, you smell so much you're gonna make them go running, I said. Now, today you're gonna be presented to society, so to speak. Come on, leave yourself, come on!
Ma'am, who are you?
Presenting the Mother Showman and her great chain of being.
Well, I am Mother Showman. I'm your new boss. You gonna make girl number 9.
Well, where's my man? He had a bit.
Girl, he skipped town. And you're lucky I found you, because you would have starved to death, or worse, you would have been thrown in jail for indecency. But it's all right now, because Mother Showman is here to guard all your interests and keep all your secrets! Now screw up! Scrub! Find the world! Ladies and gentlemen, step on in and come and see the most lowly, unfortunate being from God's great universe. Why, Mother Showman and her, now I get a wonderful surprise. Entry, and I'm disgust. Why, come and see the most ugliest things in all creativity. Well, you can see one for the price of a penny and a half, or you can come see all that on a boy's song. Why, come and see the most ugliest mystery to life.
What you looking at?
You're lovely.
Why, when you're preaching to permission for a separate our little show here was in the red until Miss Hightower came along, but that backside was gonna be back in the black. So step right up and see the Venus Hightower. Step sister to the monkey, love vinyl goddess. Well, step in, step in.
Chambers' Book of Days. Early in the present century, a poor wretched woman was exhibited in England under the appellation of the Hottentot Venus. The year was 1810, and with an intensely ugly figure, distorted beyond all European notions of beauty, she was said by those to whom she belonged to possess precisely the kind of shape which is most admired among her countrymen, the Hottentots. The year was 1810, 3 years after the bill for the abolition of the slave trade had been passed in Parliament, and among protests and denials, horror and fascination, the show went on.
We'll get used to that girl.
Extract category, newspaper.
feeling lonely? You feeling like you lost all night? Well, I too have felt that way. But if y'all come on in and get one look at the Venus hot tub, well, one look at it will have you feel like a king. The Venus Hottentot, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, she's been in this civilization here a whole year. And she's coming on, look at it.
I'm the main attraction.
Y'all the freaks that are in their second fiddles.
Oh boy. A diva.
I should be getting paid 50 coins a week. And plus a new dress every now and then, better food and a lock on my door.
I think it's time for you to go to bed. Cause when I come back there in the morning, you don't want to wake up.
I'm leaving then.
Do not test me, sweetie. There is a pub next door filled with a lot of sweaty men, and I will have them come over here and fuck your brains out!
They do it anyway.
But look, you like a daughter to me. You see, we family! And
if you was to leave or anything, well, this little thing we got going on here, it might go under. They come in when you're sleeping. I wanna go. I wanna go, please.
Where do you wanna go? Home?
No. Not home.
Then where to?
Anywhere.
Relax. Relax! Everything is going to be fantastic.
We call the Venus Hottentot.
I'm called the Venus Hottentot.
She speaks. Simple questions first. Who are you? Where are you from? Any family? Are you a witch? Where you ever be? Did you like it? Was it good? Do you want to go home? If so, when? Come on, spit it out!
No, the Venus Hottentot is only available for comment.
Don't push us, girl. We could have you locked up for life. Answer this. Are you here of your own free will, or are you under some restraint?
No, I came here to make a myth.
Hubba, 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 hubba! Order! Order!
No, I've been here this long. Go home penniless, it'd be disgraceful.
Is poverty more disgraceful than nakedness? We think not.
Shut her down! Send her home!
No, no, let me stay.
No way. Her kind bear God's bad mark. Baptized or not, they black enough the honor of our fair country. Get her out of here.
Shut her down!
No,
send her
no,
home!
No, 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 good people! Good, honest people! A bad mark. Oh, what better way to cleanse it off? By showing you my simple person, couldn't that add as a caution to you all in the Lord's eyes? Couldn't it be some sort of repentance? It would give me the chance to cleanse it off. I came here black. Give me the chance to leave here white.
Her words strike a deep chord. One more question, girl. Have you ever been indecent?
Indecent?
Nasty.
No, no, never. I'm just me.
What's that supposed to mean?
But I hide your shame is evil. I show mine. Would you like to see?
Outrage! It's an outrage! Order! 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 God! We've got a lot to think about. Recess, let's take a break.
The year was 1810, 3 years after the bill for the abolition of the slave trade had been passed in Parliament. Among protests and denials, horror and fascination, the show went on.
Hear ye, all rise and hear our ruling. It appears to the court that the person on whose behalf this suit was brought lives under no restraint. Her exhibition sounds indecent, but look at her now. She's nicely dressed. It's clear that she's got grand plots and plans to make her mark and her mint by playing outside the bounds, so that we find her person much depraved. But she says that her show is part of God's great plan, and we buy that. Besides, she has the right to make her mark just like the dancing Irish dwarf, and she seems well fed. At this time, the court rules not to rule. In closing, whatever may happen to her, it is to the credit of our great honorable country that even a female Hottentot can find the court to review her status.
Order! 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 Order!
Sir! others. Others who only wanted to use you and gain from you. Sarah, how could you? How could you use your life to possibly be a cultural appropriation for those people who would later call themselves your followers wearing bustle skirts? Sarah, how could you? How could you have black skin? How could you be anatomically torn apart, written about? How could they?
Love!
just inside the special looking place.
And from there, if I'm really quick, I'll stick my hand inside of her cage and feel.
People don't understand that and know that. People judge. People look. People don't really get to see and know the profound person that is truly behind that facade. People don't just want to know. And I mean, what about if Sarah doesn't want to do this? What about if somebody is making her do it? Do we still look at her the same way? Do we still look down on her? Because there are so many women that are taken from their homes and their families unexpectedly, and they get put in slavery. Sometimes sex slavery, sometimes domestic slavery. People don't even know that still happens today. They think that it's just something that you hear about, read about, talk about, see on the news. It's real. It's real. And it's happening every single day. Some people want to deny it. Some people don't want to get involved because they say, oh, maybe it's not my place. But by you not getting involved, you're just like them. You're just like the people that are taking and abusing them because you're not saying anything. You're not bringing attention. You're not bringing awareness. You're standing off to the side, letting it happen. And I think that's the worst part of all. People don't even realize that you're standing off to the side and letting it happen. You're allowing everything in your life to not be affected by everything in someone else's life. Do you not realize that your purpose in life is to affect others in their life that we can bring together a better tomorrow? Do you not realize that you not appreciating the color of my skin, you culturally appropriating what I do, you who think that because I share my body or because I choose not to, I should be criticized because who I am? What's wrong with you? There's nothing wrong with me. So with this being said, Sarah Bartman could be someone that's close. She could be your sister. She could be your mom, a close friend. Maybe someone that's not entirely in your life right now, but once had a significance in your life. Sarah Bartman wasn't my neighbor, but she lives down the street in the heart of my soul. Because to be honest, she looked like me. She was a woman. She fought, but was unsuccessful. Joined the fight with us and tried to correct the wrongs that have been brought to society.
I am, to her, a mere anatomical Columbus. I am, to her, a mere anatomical Columbus. I am, to her, a mere anatomical Columbus. I am to her
Don't look.
A mere anatomical Columbus.
Don't look. Cover her face.
I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus.
Don't look.
I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus. I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus.
Cover her face. Cover your eyes.
I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus.
Don't look.
I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus. I am.
Cover her face. Cover your eyes.
A mere anatomical
Columbus.
I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus. I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus. I am to her a mere anatomical
Columbus. I am to her a mere anatomical Columbus. Hottentot.
I'm called the Venus Hottentot.
She speaks. Simple questions first. Who are you? Where are you from? Any family? Are you a witch? Were you ever beaten? Did you like it? Was it good? Do you want to go home? If so, when? Come on, spit it out.
Well, the Venus Hottentot is unavailable for comment.
Don't push us, girl. We could have you locked up for life. Answer this. Are you here of your own free will, or are you under some restraint?
Oh, no, I came here to make amends.
Hubba, 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 hubba. Order, order.
I've been here this long. To go home penniless now, it would be disgraceful.
But is poverty more disgraceful than nakedness? We think not.
Shut her down! Send her home!
Oh, no, let me stay.
No way. Her kind bear God's bad mark. Baptized or not, they blacken up the honor of our fair country. Get her out of here.
Shut her down. Send her home.
No, 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 good people. Good, good, honest people. I bet bad mark. I bet it would have been solved. I show you my sinful person could, as a caution to you all in the Lord's eyes, be some sort of repentance. And I would be able to wash it off. I came here black. Give me a chance to leave here white.
Your words strike a deep chord. One more question, girl. Have you ever been indecent?
Indecent?
Nasty.
No. No, never. I'm just me.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, to hide the shame is, it's evil. I show mine. Would you like to see?
Outrage! It's an outrage! Order! 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 God! We've got a lot to think about. Recess! Recess! Let's take a break.
The year was 1810, 3 years after the bill for the abolition of the slave trade had been passed in Parliament. Among protests and denials, horror and fascination, the show went on.
Hear ye, hear ye, hear. All rise and hear our ruling. It appears to the court that the person on whose behalf this suit was brought lives under no restraint. Her exhibition sounds indecent, but look at her now. She's nicely dressed. It's clear that she's got grand plots and plans to make her mark and her mint by flying outside the bounds so that we find her person much depraved. But she says her show is part of God's great plan, and we buy that. Besides, she has the right to make her mark just like the dancing Irish dwarf. And she seems well fed. At this time, the court rules not to rule. In closing, whatever may happen to her, it is to the credit of our great honorable country that even a female Hottentot can find the court to review her status.
Order! 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 Order!
Footnote 7, historical extract, category medical. A detailed physical description of the so-called Venus Hottentot. Her hair was black and woolly, much like that of the common Negro. The slits of the eyes horizontal as in Mongols, not oblique. The brow straight,
my
wide
love,
apart, and very much flattened close to the top
my
of the
love,
nose, but jutting out at the temple above the cheekbone. Her eyes
lively,
were dark and lively.
Much like this
her
pencil.
Lips blackish, terribly thick. Her complexion very dark.
My love for you.
Her ears were much like
my
those
love.
Found in monkeys, small, weakly formed at the trigger, and vanishing behind almost completely.
Much like
her
this
breasts,
pistol.
She usually lifted and tightened.
Constructed with
men
to find his power.
Dress, but left free, they hung boldly and terminated obliquely in a blackish areola about 1.5 inches in diameter, pitted with radiating wrinkles near the center of what was a nipple
not
so flattened
months.
And obliterated as
not
to be barely
fancy.
Visible. The color of her
not
skin was on the whole a yellowish brown, almost as dark as her face.
My
her
movements
had repetition and came unexpected to Charles' mind. Well, with all respect
much
to us, the movements of a monkey.
My
above all, she
fancy.
Had a way of pushing out her lips
not
just like the mouth would do. Her personality was bright, her memory good.
My love.
She spoke no Dutch, tolerant,
much
like
that.
The minute the academy and I tried to teach her French, she danced after the fashion of all the country and played with a fairly good ear upon a little instrument she called a Jew's harp.
Fabricated.
She had no body much like a few short flecks of wool like that on her head scattered on her pubic
part.
The wonders of her lower region I fleshed out in greater detail at later meetings. This information was known, as has been said, upon the first and subsequent examination, which were performed in the office of her personal physician. As stated on the record, she submitted to these examinations as willingly as a patient submits to his doctor's eyes and hands.
Instructed with man's highest power and the hours
will last through the days,
not to a rose,
the hours,
not to a pansy,
not to a daffodil.
Compares my love,
not to a daffodil.
My love
compares my love,
not to a rose,
my love,
not to a pansy.
Which was
not to a daffodil,
not to a rose,
not to a
daffodil,
which was stretched back and forth,
compares my love,
reach through all time,
my love,
deep from my
which
heart,
which was stretched back
to hemorrhoid slime,
throughout all time, deep from my heart, to primordial slime.
He said he was a hottie tot!
Don't sniffle.
A hottie tot!
Wipe your nose.
Hottie tot Venus!
Wipe your eyes. My son's gone wild. But I have a plan. Listen up. His head has turned from your bright sun. He roams in the dark. Let me speak plain. He don't love you no more.
Oh, me?
But not that. Man, get this. Our young man wants a hottentot today. A hottentot, you know, my dear? But with some skill, we can pretend.
Pretend?
Let's get to work. I'll get you up.
Oh, make you look wild. Make you look like the hottentot. Like the hottentot?
Bring my son to his knees. Let's get to work. Let's get to work.
Footnote 9, historical extract, category medical. The female hottentot under my care has the usual falling off appearance common in women of 30 years old. Her mammae are flaccid and elongated, while her glutei muscles, the two coverings and the two prominent peculiar hemispherical cushions of fat are quite remarkable. More remarkable still are the long appendages which hang down from her pudenda.
Freak. She would have made such a splendid
lucky, lucky.
Lucky, lucky, lucky,
lucky.
Of her buttocks, we make the following remarks. The fatty cushion, aka steatopegia, was 9 inches deep. Her buttocks.
Several years later at a conference in Tübingen, the dis-rememberment of the Venus Hottentots.
Her buttocks had nearly the usual origin and insertion. But the muscular fibers were surprisingly thin and flabby, which proves to us that this protuberance of the buttocks, so common to that of the Bushman race, is of no muscular development, but rather totally dependent on the accumulation of fat. My mind was wandering, I'm sorry. Where was I? While the uterus had the ordinary form of that organ in a once or twice impregnated female, form in this study the centerpiece. The labia majora were small, the clitoris size moderate to large, and had a well-developed prepuce, all situated far more conspicuously than that of the European female. Her most remarkable features were the long appendages which hung down from her pudendum. They resembled two thorns about the thickness of a cedarwood pencil, each exactly like strips of sheepskin, slightly twisted and apparently vascular. On separating her labia, I found these appendages to be the nymphae elongated. I took up her appendages and led the right one round her right side above her gluteal projection. Similarly, I led the left one around her left side, and therein met at her spine. There was no trace of hymen. The remarkable development of the labia minora, which heretofore is so general a characteristic of that of the Hottentots, or Bushman race, was so sufficiently well-marked, and it was well-distinguished. It distinguished itself so well from others of human varieties that it made, in this study, the centerpiece of formation. The author recommends further examination of said formation. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen!
Well, you see, the Hottentot's been in this civilization here for a mere 5 months. I didn't taught everything she knows.
It wasn't real.
You were tricked. It was an illusion. You showed off your body to others that just wanted to touch and feel and violate you. What happened? They took away your dignity. Now you're left to rot, but not even to rot down to the bone. You're in some evil Satan's home. So I hope that right now, wherever you are, and I know you're up in heaven, that we are trying and trying to bring justice to people who look just like you. And now we live in a society, and some people don't even know who you are. But we praise and praise, and we'll tell your story on and on.
Tell her I'm smitten.
I think she knows.
By these knees I'm bending on, true Venus, I'm forever thine. I'll never change. Promise me the same. Mother, put that on your tongue, did in her tongue, did in her ear. What's her answer?
She promises constancy. But as we lose a skin layer every day, so will she shrug her old self off.
Shrug all you want, but keep the core. Answer. Tell her I'm smitten.
I think she knows.
By these knees I'm bending on, true Venus, I'm forever thine. I'll never change, promise me the same. Mother, put that on your tongue, then in her tongue, then in her ear. What's her answer?
She promises constancy, but as we lose a skin layer every day, so will she shrug her old self off.
It bears repeating, shrug all you want, but keep the core. Answer. Answer.
Dear heart, your true love stands before you.
Chocolate up, chocolate down, land up.
Dig up people, dead ones. Doctors pay a lot for a corpse. But resurrection's illegal, and I was always this close to getting caught. It's jail watchman's job is much more carefree.
You don't miss anything. You're lucky, watchman. I dream of home and every spare minute. Oh, it was a shitty, shitty life, but I miss it. Hey, what was that sound outside? Crowds?
Yes, you're still a star.
Don't let him in.
Don't worry.
What is that sound outside? Crowds?
Rain. It's just rain. We're having lousy weather.
I grew up near the coast, watchman. Journeyed some, worked some. Ended up here. Thought I'd be here only for a minute. Make a move. Had a plan too. He had a beard. Big bags. Tried my hand in French. Got a haircut. Claps. You get the picture. Don't look at me. Don't look.
Early in the 19th century, a young woman was exhibited in England under the appellation of the Hottentot Venus. The year was 1810, 3 years after the bill for the abolition of the slave trade had been passed in Parliament. Among protest and denial, horror and fascination, the show went on. She died 5 years later in Paris. A plaster mold was made of her body and was once displayed along with her skeleton in the Musée de l'Homme.
My love for you, my love, is artificial, fabricated, much like this epistle.
The height measured after death was 4 feet, 11 and a half inches. The total weight of the body is 98 pounds, avoirdupois. As an aside, I should say, that as to the value of the information that I present to you today, there can be no doubt its significance. And it will be felt far further than our select community. All that in mind, I understand that my yield is long in length. And while my finds are complete compensation for the amount of labor expended upon them, I do invite you, distinguished colleagues and gentlemen, if you need relief, take yourself a breath in the lobby. My voice will surely carry past these walls. And if not, my journal is being published, forthcoming in the Royal College of Journal of Anatomy. Merely as an aside, gentlemen.
My love for you, my love, is artificial, fabricated, much like this epistle.
The height measured after death was 4 feet and 11 and a half inches. The total weight of the body was 98 pounds I've worked you up. In the following notes, my attention is chiefly directed to the more perishable, soft structures of the body. The skeleton will form the subject of further examination. External characteristics. The great amount of subcutaneous fat were quite surprising. On the front of the thigh, for instance, fat measured 1 inch in thickness. On the thighs of the breast, fat measured 4 inches deep. On the buttocks proper, rested the fatty cushion, aka sciatopegia, the details of which I'll relate in due course. The skin, prevailing color, orange-brown, tolerably uniform in tint on all parts of the body, save the abdomen and thighs, 2 shades darker. The palms of the hands and the soles of the feet were almost white.
Love's corpse stands in museum.